Here we are showing the large model of the generator, which produces in excess of 800 volts. The device only weighs about 1.5 kilograms, and it's made of standard materials. It's not sophisticated in any way, materials that we can virtually get off the shelf. And my colleagues are showing the diameter and the size of it here. It's about 17 inches in diameter, and it's about four inches high on the side of it. And basically the generator is, what we're showing here now is the smaller version of the generator, which is about 6 inches in diameter, weighs about 0.5 pound, and this unit produces about 185 volts. There's a gyroscopic effect in the generator as you turn it through the air, even though it's solid state. Here we're showing a scene of the inverter, which is three times the size and three times the weight of the generator. So we can drop the power down from 185 volts and 5,000 hertz down to 110 volts and 50 to 60 cycles, so we can run American appliances off the generator. And we'll shortly show a short demonstration of it powering a standard American television set. The inverter is just standard materials, standard electronics, so there's no problem in producing this device. The generator itself, as we said before, is just made out of standard ceramic type materials. In its operation, being solid state, there's no moving parts, and when you hold it in your hand, you can actually feel this gyroscopic effect in the air as you turn it, and there's a sort of a resonance as the device is on, as you can see my colleague just holding it here now, and that's actually producing 185 volts there now as he's holding it in his hand. It has many applications, from powering a wristwatch to a cell phone to home appliances, right up to vehicles, trucks, tractors, ships, aeroplanes. So there's no limit to what this thing can actually drive, and you can power a house with something the size of a briefcase. So it's got potential all over the world. Here's my colleague holding it in his hand, so he can actually feel the resonance in it and the gyroscopic effect as the generator is actually producing 185 volts now. And there's another colleague of mine who's just going to hold it and feel this same resonance and gyroscopic effect, which is quite amazing, seeing it's solid state and there's no moving parts, but because it's tuned to the earth, that's why it happens. Here it is producing 185 volts on the standard digital multimeter, and now we're going to just power just a standard 100 watt light bulb, as you can see the light on in the back there. And in this part of the demonstration, the generator is on. We hook it on to the inverter, and you can see the television actually operating now. The flash is on the American television because of the frames per second, but in actual fact, because of the camera I was using caused that. But normally, the picture was perfectly normal in the demonstration. So we can see that here's just one simple demonstration of the device actually operating, sitting on a boardroom table, and my colleague's just feeling it now in operation. And we move from this point of the demonstration to showing another phase where we're actually testing the EMF off the television set, which we saw was about 10. And here near the generator, it actually produces no EMF flux at all, which shows the generator has no side effects in any way. Here we're actually showing one of my colleagues pushing it across the table to show the washboard effect of the generator on the smooth glass top table, because you're actually breaking the gravitational lines of force as you're pushing the generator across the table. And so what we're doing, what my colleague will do here, we're just taking it down the other end of the table so we can just show it powering 10 100 watt light bulbs, which are wired in series here as he's doing that now, to show that there's no gimmicks or tricks to it. And in a few seconds we will we'll hook that up in series to the generator, and you'll see all the lights come on. It's like lighting up 10 rooms in a house, and there they are there. So that's the generator, and it's got potential to virtually change our world as it is today, because there's no pollution, there's no emission, there's no noise, there's no byproducts, and it's being made of simple materials. And we'll go on from this frame here to show another interesting phenomenon of the generator. Here we're showing the lights, of course, again, but in the next phase of it, we actually show how the generator can be depowered and produce an electric flame. And this is the demonstration here. My colleague's just turning it around. He depowers it, and if you can consider an 8-cylinder engine with 8 spark plugs, we're now taking 7 spark plugs away from this and using only 1 spark plug, so we're only 1/10 of the power, and yet it's dangerous enough to kill a man. We put the leads on the output there, and we'll just show here 2 electrodes. When you bring them close in touch with each other, you'll actually see an electric flame that comes off the end of those electrodes, which is quite unique, because it's not an arc, it's an actual electric flame. And that could have many uses, because you could have an electric fire that looks like a real wood fire without having to be burning any wood at all. So that's the total demonstration of the generator, and anyway, we'll be talking to you in detail about that. This is just a video to show the basic system actually operating. Thank you.